Right about now, we have a lady in studio. She goes by the name Cyprian, and she makes cards. Yes, as beautiful as the one I am holding, and many more we'll see. So we'll get to know her more about her craft and how you can get these beautiful cards if you wanted them. So welcome to the studio.
Thank you.
How are you feeling?
I'm feeling ears. I'm feeling happy. I'm feeling lucky. Yeah.
Thank you so much for coming through.
Thank you for having me.
So kindly introduce yourself and maybe tell us how you came about making cards.
Okay, so my name is Cyprian Korir. Mm-hmm. I'm a student. Mm-hmm. Yes, and aside from that, mm-hmm. I make cards on the side. Mm-hmm. It's like a talent that I have. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I make different cards like greeting cards, mm-hmm. invitation cards, mm-hmm. wedding cards, mm-hmm. birthday cards. Mm-hmm. It's a wide range.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So what motivated you to make the cards and when did you start?
So, it started as a craft when I was still young. I remember when I was in lower primary, favorite subject ilikuwa art and craft. I liked cutting papers, I liked coloring, evo. So it continued developing when I was in upper primary. That's when I started making beautiful cards, just small. By that time, I didn't have resources. So I just make like beautiful papers, then I'd give my friends. When in high school, that's when like I discovered I could actually do it.
Yeah.
That's when I started doing it for commercial purposes.
Mm-hmm. In high school?
Yeah, in high school.
So you were making money in high school?
I was making a lot of money from cards. When I was in Form 1, actually I remember I was in Form 1 at that time in 2014. I made one card. I was just making it for the fun of it.
Yeah.
And then someone was like, wow, this is beautiful. How much is it? And I was like, wow, I could actually sell this. So when we went home, I bought so many materials, I bought everything, and I started making them. So people would buy them from me, and they would like it. So I was like, the main person who was making cards in my school.
Zile za kutumia watu.
For success. Thank you. Also that, because we used to have fun kids. Unazikumbuka?
Yeah.
So ikaanza hivyo. Now, after high school, I was like, I wanted to start, but again, nimeingia campus. There's a lot in between. Yeah. So in 2018 is when I got out of my comfort zone. I bought all the resources I needed. I established a page. I became a brand. Yeah, so I started making cards. And then at first it was hard, you know, like awingiangi tu even okakwa established.
True.
Yeah, it's a whole journey.
So what kind of materials do you use to make the cards?
I used embellished papers. I use crepe papers. I use ribbons. I use...
Could you like
display
show them?
This is an example. This is like a thank you card. Yeah, it's just simple. I used embellished papers, then I used a plain paper for the polka dots. There's the red ribbon that is like lace material. Then there's the small diamonds and a big ribbon. On the inside is just a small space for the person to write the message they want to communicate, and then some small design over there.
Okay, so what makes your cards unique other than the ones we see in the supermarkets and stuff? Like, what makes you unique?
The fact that makes me unique is I use materials from like anything. Anything that I see, and it just inspires me. Like, I see, when I see something, just a random ribbon, and I'm like, this could look good in a white paper or a black paper. I get the idea. That is unique already. Yeah, it's not like when you walk in the supermarket, you know, like the cards that are there displayed, they're just similar.
Yeah, all the same. And even when we have, maybe for example, Tamiya success cards, we see the same old things.
The same old designs.
Yeah, so what are some of the challenges that you went through when, from the time you decided that I need to get out of my comfort zone and actually make cards commercially full time?
The biggest challenge was first getting to know my clients and making them like, no, I am here, I exist, I make cards, this is how I do it, this is how you can get to me. It was really hard at first before I established myself, and then again, you need to know people in the industry that you're in, who you can collaborate with, who can help you, like The biggest way that I got my clients mm-hmm. were through referrals. Yeah. I would make like a card and then they like it mm-hmm. and you say when they're sending it to someone, mm-hmm. the person who's been sent through the card, they're mm-hmm. like, this is beautiful. Wow. Can you hook me up?
Yeah.
Like that. Mm-hmm. Besides from that, I would mm-hmm. hook up with MCs or mm-hmm. people who do events. Mm-hmm. So like
planners.
When they, yeah, planners. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so like let's say they have a wedding, mm-hmm. they could get me that contract.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then I get to meet with the client, mm-hmm. we arrange everything. Mm-hmm. When we reach an understanding, mm-hmm. I get the contract, I do them a good job. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So currently, you're just doing it alone, right?
I'm doing it alone. Mm-hmm.
So in the future, would you, how do you vision? Do you have a name for the
card? Yeah. The cards? It was just a simple, when I was starting, mm-hmm. I was mm-hmm. like, I want a name that my clients will find it easy to, you see, like, let's say you're on Instagram and you're typing mm-hmm. something, you're looking for cards, yeah. definitely you'll type mm-hmm. cards. So I was yeah. like, so for them to find me accessible, mm-hmm. let me just find a simple name. Cards. So I started Cards Kenya, uh-huh. just that. Uh-huh. They know I'm making cards, they know mm-hmm. I'm located in Kenya, mm-hmm. like that. Mm-hmm. So Cards Kenya is the name of the brand. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So what's your vision for Cards Kenya?
I want it to grow. Mm-hmm. I want, like, let's say in 5 to 6 years, mm-hmm. my biggest dream is to have a bridal and events mm-hmm. planning company. Mm-hmm. So besides just making cards
yeah.
for just small mm-hmm. things, I could do big, like, I want to host weddings as well.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Aside from making the wedding cards, mm-hmm. I plan the weddings. Planning and uh-huh. hosting everything. I want to do that. I want it to be so big. Uh-huh. Yeah. And then for commercial cards, let's say besides making the invitation cards, mm-hmm. I arrange for you, let's say the bridal shower,
yeah,
corporate
yeah.
events, mm-hmm. like that. Mm-hmm. I want it to be more than just cards.
Mm-hmm. So I know this is common knowledge, but yes. At what event can people give cards? Ama, why do you need cards?
You need cards because cards are needed. You don't need an event to give someone a card. Mm-hmm. You could be telling someone thank you. You mm-hmm. could be saying sorry. Mm-hmm. You could be like just a friendly card. You mm-hmm. want to make your friend feel special. You can make someone feel special by just giving them a beautiful card. You don't need a reason. It doesn't need to be someone's mm-hmm. birthday or someone's graduation party or a wedding. Mm-hmm. Cards, mm-hmm. we should normalize mm-hmm. giving cards
giving
to people.
Cards, if you can just hold your card still.
Like
yeah,
this.
Like that, yeah, like that. Mm. Yeah, so you don't need an occasion to give
You don't
a card.
Need an occasion.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Okay, so very interesting. And I would just like you to advise young ladies out there, even young fellas. I think today we've had so many things about sticking in school mm. and still hustling out there and, you know, going after your passions.
Mm.
Yeah.
So the main thing I would want to say is, like, we need to know how to create that balance. You have a talent, you're still in school. Mm-hmm. You can't say, just because I'm in school, I can't pursue my talent or I can't pursue my passion mm-hmm. or I'm going to pursue my passion and forget school. You need to create that balance. Like, let's say that little time that you have, do what makes you happy. For me, it's making cards. Sometimes I'm stressed, there's a lot of schoolwork, and what gives me that happiness is making a card. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay, so please, let's pursue our passions, even if we are in school, maybe at any time totally stressed, like you have said.
Yeah.
So you have something for our fans today and all those people who are watching.
Yeah.
Kindly give away the goodies.
So besides from presenting the cards I came with today, I have a giveaway going on.
Camera
four. Oh, this one?
Yeah.
Okay. So my official page on Instagram is called cards_Kenya. You can also write me through my email, which is cardskenya@gmail.com. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So the first 10 people mm-hmm. to follow me on my page, Cards Kenya, you're going to get, and tag 3 of their friends, please. Yeah. You're going to get 2 cards of your choice. Any, if you want a birthday card, a Valentine's card, a thank you card, just name it. Choose your color that is according to your preference. And you could do it.
They've started.
Yeah,
that was fast. That was really fast.
So if someone wanted to learn how to make cards, mm. is it something that comes naturally or could you teach them if they wanted to?
That is a long question, but I would say mm-hmm. If you have that passion, start exploring it. Mm-hmm. And if you feel like you're really serious, mm-hmm. how do I even say this? Like, okay, for now, I'm not offering partnership positions,
yeah.
but maybe as I grow, you can reach out to me. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. So, sawa. So thank you so much for coming through. Mm-hmm. Maybe share your pages once again so that people can follow and link up with you if they wanted cards.
Okay. So my official Instagram page is cards_Kenya. And then my email is cardskenya@gmail.com. That's my email. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
They've started following, by the way. I don't think they have thank tagged you, their
thank
friends.
Thank you, thank you. Tag your three friends.
Also, I have to tag some.
Yes, you have to tag three of your friends.
Ngoja.
Sasa, now that una follow, you want a card, right?
Yeah, yes. What's that?
Unataka kadi ya nini?
Siko sure. So, unajua hizi vitu zimekuja tu haraka haraka. Na ninacheki kuna something new is coming. Okay, okay. Mother's Day. Mother's Day inakuwa nini?
Mother's Day iko mbali kidogo.
And then? But kila siku. Yeah. I think I can go
for it. Tumeambiwa au uitaji sherehe.
Oh.
You just get the card, take it to your mother.
Sawa, inipotea Mother's Day na Father's Day.
Okay.
Yes. Sawa. Right. And then besides that, there's something I'd like to mention.
Okay.
So Valentine's is upcoming next month. Mm-hmm. I'll be doing gift hampers. Mm-hmm. So besides cards, you're going to get a basket of, let's say, wine, roses, a card, and chocolates to gift your special ones.
Yeah.
Ah. Sasa ringekuwa leo lakini sawa haina shida.
We'll talk to you all the time, okay? So thank you so much for coming through.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, we wish you all the best in your endeavors.
Thank you.
And we wish to see Cards Kenya grow bigger.
Thank you.
Yeah. So that was Cyprian from Cards Kenya, and as she has said, and by the way, she's quite young. Sawa. She's quite young, so pursue your passions. Go to school. It doesn't stop there.
Yeah.
Okay? So, yeah. So, let's get to enjoy some music.